2 miles beneath the dust and rattlesnakes lies a buried treasure that men are willing to risk their lives to get. 100% Texas crude.
He's got a blow!
This is the ultimate race to strike it rich. And modern-day cowboys are willing to dig deep.
You gotta keep it drilling, rain or shine, man!
Just for a taste.
Oh, man, I live for this.
Of black gold. Tonight, three rigs go head-to-head, attempt to strike the same reserve.
We got a heck of a well.
They'll fight the clock.
Tell me one good reason you're 6 hours late.
The machines and their own inner demons.
I guarantee y'all will get tired, ass.
On the Longhorn rig, which means facing danger at every turn.
Whoa.
Hang on to it.
Let's go.
There's an oil boom in West Texas, and they've got no time to waste. The Longhorn is one of three competing rigs racing to hit black gold.
Get your tongs fixed up. Get ready. Let's go.
They all have just 50 days to drill 3 holes. If they're lucky, the Longhorn will get to the oil first and strike it big. But on the rig floor, they face three relentless threats. They could get slammed by the 500-pound iron tongs. Ripped by the steel chain. Or crushed by the 10-ton blocks. But today, they're focused on one thing. Getting that drill bit 10,000 feet deep. Where they hope to hit the next huge oil strike. This is how oil wells are drilled. One 30-foot length of pipe at a time. You screw one in, drill 30 feet, and add another. Do this about 350 times, and you've drilled a hole 2 miles into the earth.
Clean up your better hand than that, make them buy, son.
Gerald's the driller, the man in charge on the rig.
Got flashing tongs for you.
He's drilled holes all over the world, but around here, he's known as the toughest driller in the business.
I'm a driller. Basically, I'm responsible for keeping this thing turning to the right for 8 hours. Keeping my crew lined out, keeping everybody safe. Come on, push that head of this tongs around.
Gerald leads a crew of 3 men, known in the oil field as roughnecks. Every driller's got his own style. Gerald leads his men like a drill sergeant.
That's enough.
What he says goes.
Hey, you're in the wrong damn spot. You better move quick.
If I see them doing something that they shouldn't do, I'll just stop. Say, hey, no, don't do it. And I'm usually not that nice about it when I say it.
If I ever see you stick your finger in the bottom of that pipe, I'll cut that son of a bitch up.
Don't put your fingers nowhere you wouldn't put your peck. When I lost that thumb, it took less than a second for that thumb to come off my hand. And when I looked down and seen that white bone laying on that black glove, I ain't bullshit nobody. My ass landed right there. Just like that.
Very dangerous right there, boys.
I mean, I have beat my body to death before, too. And so I try to teach these kids not to do that.
There you go, right here. Come on.
But I'd rather it happen to me. You know? If somebody's got to take it out here, I'd rather take it myself.
Come
There's millions to be made if you can strike oil. So Gerald and his team have plenty of competition digging for black gold. Just 500 yards east of the veteran Longhorn is the state-of-the-art Viking rig. They're banking on technology to give them the edge.
Yeah, it's brand new. It's right out of the package. It's a roughneck Christmas out here.
The Viking is an $8 million machine. The man in charge is Wayne, and he knows all too well how quickly things can turn ugly on a rig.
I had a friend of mine, he was killed on a drilling rig. What happened, the scoping cylinder broke. The blocks fell down and landed on top of him. Hell, that's probably 10 or 12,000 pounds falling out of the sky. He didn't have much of a chance. I hate to see anything like that happen. Hell, he had wife and kids.
When those blocks fall, there's no time to get out of the way.
Send them down to me, drill.
Hey, where's our hook?
And one of Wayne's roughnecks is standing under them right now.
Oh, watch out, watch out.
You know, if somebody got hurt out here, I would never get over it.
Wayne looks out for his crew, and that makes him a driller everyone wants to work for.
Wayne, I love that man. I just feel real privileged to be able to work with him because he's from the old school roughnecking, man.
Wayne's old school style means treating his crew like family.
A couple of the guys on the crew call me dad there, I guess because I'm such an old bastard. But
Wayne made his first hole 27 years ago, before any of his roughnecks were even born.
Yeah, these are like my sons. Call them the triplets.
Wayne and his crew are putting in their first pipe.
Digger!
The start of the brand new Vikings' very first hole.
I got it, don't worry, buddy.
They're under my supervision and my care, you know, so really their lives are in my hands running the rig.
While Wayne keeps an eye on his crew, the brand new rig has a computer that tracks everything underground. It tells them exactly when to push the rig harder and when to pull back. They're betting this will give the Viking an edge in the race. But it's not broken in yet. 1 minute it's drilling, and the next, there's big trouble.
We'll have to take that off.
Take the chain off.
Pull the rotary chain out.
All right.
Slide the torque wheel over.
It costs almost $50,000 every day just to run the Viking. Every hour it's down means more money lost.
It's out there. We got a rainstorm. Lightning off in the horizon. And competition less than 50 yards away. They've already got pipe up in there, Derek, so we're a little bit behind.
While the Longhorn may be Viking's closest rival, just down the road, there's one more rig competing to hit pay dirt. The massive Big Dog is the final rig to enter the race. 200,000 pounds of iron and steel, 15 stories tall. It may not be computerized, but it's got 25% more horsepower than the other rigs. But there's no old pro holding the leash of this big dog.
Get you some, baby, get you some.
During a boom, experienced drillers like Wayne and Gerald are hard to find. Driller Tim hasn't spent decades in the oil field, and he's still earning his crew's respect.
Push my hand like that,
Doc. Tim, sometimes he's just sitting there like he's watching a video game. He just gets in his own where you can say something to him, he won't answer you. But I do trust him.
The crew has to trust the driller. He controls everything on the rig floor. With the flip of a switch, he can raise the pipe, release the tong, or shut down the pumps for the drilling mud.
We're waiting on you, Drill.
But Tim's about to make a rookie mistake. He forgot to shut off the pumps. That mud's supposed to stay in the well to wash out the hole.
Damn it.
Without mud, the drill bit will grind to a halt.
You didn't kick the pump up?
I had my hand up my ass.
That's a worm move right there. That's a worm move.
A worm is an oil field rookie.
You want to kick the pump back?
Nah, I wormed out. That pump's too good.
This job's already hard enough. The slippery floor's not making it any easier. Tim has to show his crew he's got what it takes. Their lives are in his hands. Back at the brand new Viking rig, it's been a frustrating first day for Wayne and his crew. Due to mechanical problems, they've already fallen behind the Big Dog and Longhorn rigs. A few hours of repair and $8,000 of lost time later,
that's good.
They're finally ready to drill. Until...
I swear to God, I'm gonna kill that engineer that designed this motherfucker. Shut it down! With those guys over there making hole, making connections, it kind of pisses us off. We work hard and we're the best roughnecks in the oil field. That makes us, that's what's going to get us ahead of them.
Coming up, the old Longhorn makes its move.
Unless something breaks on this rig, there's no way they'll catch it.
Push me nuts!
Will the smallest roughneck survive on the rig?
Whoa.
And before the end of the week, one of these drillers will be fired.
You know better than that.
On day one, the brand new Viking rig has had nothing but equipment problems.
What a hater.
Shut it down!
They fixed the breakdown with the rotary chain, but now something else has gone wrong.
What's going on is the clutch is dragging on the hub right here. Some way we're gonna have to get it spaced up where it's clear of the hub where it don't drag.
If the clutch is screwed up, that $60,000 bit won't turn.
So this is what we're talking about, new equipment. All the hands in the world, best drillers. Best technology God provided us, and you still can't fix stupid.
The next morning, the veteran Longhorn rig is widening their lead over the Viking.
That brand new rig over there, they made the brag that they were going to out-drill us.
The 64-year-old rig was brought out of retirement to punch more holes in West Texas. But the crew is confident in their proven rig.
They ain't going to touch us, there's no way. I mean, we're making some hole. I doubt they...
Unless something breaks on this rig, there's no way they'll catch it.
Driller Gerald has his roughnecks putting pipe in the ground fast. But he's keeping a close eye on the crew's rookie. Or worm.
My name's Philip, but on the rig, they call me Peanut.
Come on, Peanut. One more time, Jeff.
Because I'm short and I'm small.
The worm's the low man on the totem pole. He doesn't understand the dangers on the rig. And Peanut's barely 5 feet tall and just 120 pounds.
Everybody got the fingers out?
He's almost too small to work the iron, but Gerald's determined to turn him into a roughneck.
He don't have a lot of experience, but he's got a big heart. And so that means a lot to me.
A lot of things here are kind of difficult for me, you know. But I just put in my mind I can do it and I get it done, you know. So I just stay determined.
And there's Peanut, hard working little fart. Push, Peanut! Push!
In 3 hours today, Gerald, Peanut, and the team have put 8 pieces of pipe in the ground, 240 feet closer to the pay zone.
two of you, man. It's gonna take both of you.
On a good day, a crew puts about 20 pieces into the ground. First, the driller raises the last 30-foot section of pipe out of the hole. Then the roughnecks unscrew the top of the pipe with the tongs.
It's just like two big pipe wrenches to loosen that pipe.
They attach it to a new pipe waiting on the floor with the spinning chain.
That chain is a fast, efficient way to screw pipe together is what it is. As you notice, we wrap it on that bottom piece of pipe, and that boy throws it.
One more time.
And when he throws it, all he's doing is moving it from the bottom piece to the top piece. Chain bites on that pipe just like a pipe wrench. And it will spin that pipe as I pull on that chain.
That chain may be the fastest way to screw pipe together, but it's also the fastest way to get yourself killed on a rig.
I'm not gonna say I'm afraid of the chain, but I've got respect for it, you know, because I've seen a lot of people get hurt, you know.
It don't matter if it's across your face, across your arm, across your chest, or around your neck. When that something hits you, it hits you hard.
I mean, it's obviously dangerous. I mean, good God, it's wild as first time you see it.
Oh, it ain't made up yet.
Hang on to it, baby. Hang on to it.
Whoa.
It hit me.
Be nut.
Okay.
Get up.
A few miles away, oil man Mike LaMonica doesn't know about the accident on the Longhorn yet, but his mind is on the rig.
This well, from getting the land, from getting it drilled, it's going to run about $1.7, $1.8 million.
It's a huge gamble, but risk takers like Mike have been making and losing fortunes in the oil fields of West Texas since the Great Depression. The area sits on top of a petroleum-rich zone known as the Permian Basin. Geological and seismic tests determine where the oilmen put their rigs, but the only sure way to find the black gold trapped in the rock below is to drill 2 miles into the earth. For this well, the Longhorn is only budgeted for 2 weeks of drilling time. More than that, and Mike starts losing money by the second.
If this doesn't work out, then I'm busted.
If we make a well here, then everybody...
For Mike, getting oil from Texas isn't just about making money.
It's very vital to our country to have oil, other than get it from the Middle East, which, you know, I've got a lot of friends that are over there right now fighting, and I hate it. I can't stand it. But so anything we can do in our own country to make our own oil and to take care of the American people, I want to do it. Get those boys home. There's oil. Texas tea.
This well alone adds almost 100,000 barrels a year to America's oil reserves.
This is called Wolfcamp oil, so it's a yellow oil. Very light. This is beautiful oil.
So what you're seeing here is just pure oil.
This is what we want to see.
At current prices, this well is making Mike $20,000 a day. But it costs twice that to run a rig like the Longhorn for a day. And this new play is especially risky. Mike has doubled down and is drilling with the Longhorn and the brand new Viking. But there's no guarantee either rig will ever strike oil. Every hole Mike drills is another multi-million dollar roll of the dice.
I love to gamble, and I can't think of a better way to gamble than oil and gas.
Back at the old Longhorn,
Peanut.
The rig's worm Peanut has just taken a shot to the head from the spinning chain.
Whoa!
looked up and seen that chain come around that pipe, it went like this to Peanut's face. Within that far of that boy's face. Peanut.
Okay.
Get up.
Luckily, it looks like he's all right.
He let go and it's just swirled around. I just moved like that and I dug my head. Probably because I'm short, I could have ducked it easier, no?
Chain gets away from me time to time. I mean, he got away from me a little bit.
I did kind of get aggravated because he didn't let it go.
Apologize to him or whatever, but he knows I didn't mean it. And it didn't get him. It's close, but it didn't.
I don't trust nothing on these rigs, you know? I don't trust nothing. Nobody, you know?
Coming up, a night out could spell the end for Big Dog's driller, Tim.
I whooped your damn ass, mother...
And the Viking faces disaster. At the giant Big Dog rig, driller Tim's kept a steady pace since his mistake with the pumps and is earning his crew's confidence.
Try to work fast, but safely.
Yeah. Hey.
Big Dog.
In just 3 days, he's drilled over 1,200 feet, putting Big Dog within a few hundred feet of catching the Longhorn rig. But Tim always has to look out for Big Dog's worm, Derek, a 23-year-old wild card.
I mean, Derek, he's still a worm. You can't trust him. I mean, I don't trust him.
Derek never thought he'd end up on a rig, but in West Texas, it's hard to escape the pull of the oil field.
Everybody thinks they're gonna go to college. We're all back in the oil field doing what our dads did when we were kids. Was gonna do big things, and well, here I am.
Woo! With bonuses and overtime, even the worm, the low man on the totem pole, can bring home $75,000 a year.
We're the West Texas Dream. This is it right here. Big money out in the oil field.
Derek's about to earn that big money. The crew has to change out the drill bit for a fresh one. A high-end bit costs up to $60,000. And they may go through five of them to get to the pay zone. Replacing the bit is the nastiest, filthiest job on the rig. And it's unavoidable. The roughnecks have to pull every length of pipe out of the hole to get to the drill bit at the bottom. It's called tripping pipe.
It started getting a little wet on us and everybody getting muddy and it's pretty fun there.
The drilling mud still in the pipe has to go somewhere. The driller can't do anything about it, so his roughnecks just have to deal with it.
That tastes like money though. That's money right there, baby.
It took 6 hours, but the Big Dog crew tripped 1,250 feet of pipe.
Ah, there it is.
And replaced the drill bit.
All in a day's work.
Got it, bro.
Tim and his roughnecks are coming together as a team. And tonight, the crew is taking Tim out for his 31st birthday. Things going so well on the rig.
Cheers, right here.
Cheers.
No one's looking to cut loose more than Tim.
Hey, happy birthday. Happy birthday, Tim.
Can I get 8 shots of Guadalupe?
Was it Guadalupe?
Yeah.
You're already drunk, man.
I ain't drunk. It's my birthday.
Tim's trying to keep the party going inside. But outside, Derek's trying to start a party of his own.
Hey, I'm gonna call you tomorrow night.
Huh?
I wanna hang out with you.
Okay, well,
you're single, right?
Yes.
Yeah, me too, right on.
Whatever, let me see your hand.
Uh-uh.
You're not.
For real, though, for real, you're so fine. Like,
the Big Dog crew might have some luck tonight. But there's no luck on the brand new Viking rig. Wayne and his crew haven't drilled for 2 days. And with the well just 200 feet deep, they've barely scratched the surface.
Hang on a second, guys, we lost pump pressure. Yeah, we lost 400 pounds of pressure. Let's go see what the problem is.
Pumps, both pumps went down. Now our flow line's full of sediment. That ain't supposed to happen.
She's gonna blow!
Something's blocking the flow lines, and the drilling mud is spewing out everywhere it shouldn't. If the guys can't shut down the pumps, the valves could burst.
Oh my God!
Sending 20-pound chunks of shrapnel flying across the rig.
Always something, man. Always something.
Always something, dude.
Wayne and his crew have shut down the pumps, but they still can't drill until they figure out what caused the problem.
We gotta go through and make sure there's nothing messing it up or clogging it up on these valves.
This is make it or break it time for Viking. If Wayne can't get the bit back in the hole, Mike LaMonica will find somebody who can.
I think if we don't get her going tonight, there may be some new faces out here tomorrow.
Hold on, Jesse. All right.
We found one of these plastic caps underneath one of the suction valves.
No one knows how that little plastic cap got into the pumps, but it just cost Mike LaMonica another shift and almost $20,000.
Something so small can have such a big impact.
While the Viking crew is dealing with endless trouble on the rig, Big Dog driller Tim has brought his troubles on the rig out to the bar.
There ain't nobody out that motherfucking rig can run that rig faster than me.
Yeah, and I know that, but that's good.
Well, I mean, why does everybody come down on me?
I'm not coming down on you, Tim.
Tim, look at me.
I'll whoop your damn ass, motherfucker.
Tim, look at me.
You want some?
It's 4 a.m. Tim and his crew have to get back on the Big Dog in just a few hours. If they don't sober up, one night out could cost them their jobs. Coming up, Gerald's a man short.
You better be bleeding or I'm killing your ass.
And later, Wade doesn't want anyone telling him how to run his rig.
They better watch it out and their down.
Back at the massive Big Dog rig, it's time for Tim and his crew to take over. Derek's here, but last night's partying took a toll on him.
Man, I was half f***ed up this morning from last night, thinking about coming in, but I tell you what, I'm just gonna power through this. Make it another day. Make that money, gotta be here.
But Derek's surprised to find out he's the only one there.
I'll whoop your damn ass, motherfucker.
Tim and the rest of the crew are nowhere to be found.
I'm just showing up. I'm here.
A no-show driller is a serious problem for the rig supervisors, who have to keep the Big Dog digging.
We hadn't heard nothing out of Tim. I've called him and can't get a hold of him.
If Tim and his crew don't show up, the overnight crew will have to pull a double shift with Derek helping out.
My daddy was scheduled for a triple bypass today, and I can't even be there.
This rig is drilling for a legendary local oil man, Autry Stevens.
Can you make oil appear down there?
Autry has survived the boom and bust roller coaster to become one of the biggest independent oil men in West Texas. he has more than 4,000 wells. At current prices, his companies produce $1.5 million worth of oil every day.
Which well is that rig 23 on?
Autry is more established than Mike LaMonica, and he's drilling in a proven area. That means higher expectations.
This is one we had a lot of drilling problems with.
Autry knows to always keep a close eye on his drillers.
Driller is the key guy. You can have a great new rig out here, and if you've got some worms running into, you know, you really don't have anything, you're going to have problems.
Tim's no-show will not please the boss.
Hurry up, let's go!
Autry Stevens won't put up with drillers who cost him time and money.
I think they'll be back tomorrow.
Over at the old Longhorn, Gerald's crew is making good progress. They've already drilled almost 2,000 feet.
One more time.
He's got Viking and Big Dog in his rearview mirror, choking on his dust. But now he's got a problem of his own. His worm Peanut's not here.
Get off your lazy ass and call me now. Bye. Peanut didn't show up this morning, and I don't know what his problem is.
Probably stayed out drinking too late or something. Now he's just...
I don't know. He'll have some good story to tell me, though. You bet on that.
I want to hear stories about I don't give a if he got none or not. He's come up with something. Twist off. I need to at least get a story out of him.
The crew already has enough work of their own to do. And now they have to carry Peanut's weight too.
It's difficult on the other guys when you're one short. Because that's what's all going.
Without Peanut's help, the Longhorn crew is working at half speed, only making one connection an hour. Being short a man is costing Mike LaMonica $1,000 every hour.
When somebody's not here, it's hard. It makes it hard.
Come on!
When the work gets harder, it gets more dangerous. But right now, staying safe takes a back seat to picking up Peanut slack.
Get him off, let's go! You better be bleeding or I'm killing your ass. Call me. When they don't show up, I just fire them. I don't mess with you.
Coming up, is it too late for Peanut?
Sorry, don't do me a damn bit of good.
And 5 tons of steel are out of control on the Viking.
That's no bueno, no bueno at all, senor.
At the Longhorn rig, day 4's been slow going for Gerald's crew.
Man, you got to let them slide around like that. You got to get 2 latches on and pull you some cable.
They're still leading the race to hit oil. But without Peanut, they've only drilled 130 feet today. Their worst pace so far.
I can't get the little bastard on the phone. I've called him about a dozen times. He won't answer the phone. I don't know why.
Finally, halfway through the day, Peanut shows up.
What the f*** coming to work at noon?
What else you supposed to do?
It's your damn ass dress, boy.
I am.
You've been here at 5:30 this morning.
Sorry,
don't do me a damn bit of good.
Peanut's so worried he'll lose his job, he hits the rig floor in his street clothes.
What I need to do? He can tell he felt bad.
Tell me one good reason you're 6 hours late.
I just thought I'm sorry. I'll make it up to him. That's what I'm trying to, you know. Make it double work harder.
Fine beer, I know that.
Come on, Peanut. One more time, Dad.
Peanut's trying to make up for lost time, but on a rig, being in a hurry can get you hurt.
He's a good kid, and I want to see him stay straight. And so I'm going to give him another chance.
but I'm going to hoorah him for a while. I'm going to mess with him.
I called you, I bet you 50 times this damn morning.
So he told me next time I'll be fired, so just got to watch out and get up early and be more responsible about myself.
Don't let it happen again. Your ass be out that door.
At the brand new Viking, it's been 3 days of breakdowns, $150,000 in lost time, and just 630 feet drill.
Hold on it, lady. Come on, woman.
But now, Wayne and his crew are finally ready to get back into the race.
We're making some serious holes now.
The Viking is drilling again. The lost time has put a serious dent in Mike LaMonica's wallet.
Okay, let's go through where we are. Let's start out with Viking 2.
We had 18 hours of rig repair yesterday. Now we have Perfecto stand on location on that rig.
He doesn't want to lose any more money. So he's sending in some insurance.
My name is Frank Cadillo Jr. I work for the EXL.
Watch your head, watch your face, Dave.
Perfecto is the company man. When a rig isn't running right, he comes in to lay down the law. He's here to supervise Wayne and make sure the rig makes money.
Well, tell me something, tell me.
But Wayne, like any driller, doesn't want anyone looking over his shoulder.
If I see the company man coming up here in my doghouse, my first thought is you need to get your ass back down there in your trailer.
I'll be able to catch up to the bastards over there.
Wayne's driving the rig hard and fast to make up for lost time, but it's risky. Torque from the fast-turning drill bit is causing the blocks to swing.
Blocks keep swinging whenever the RPMs jump up there. That's no bueno, no bueno at all, senor.
If those 10 tons of iron fall, they could lose the well and the lives of anyone on the rig.
Got 100 something right now, 100 feet only.
Okay.
Perfecto wants that bit slowed down now.
110
RPM,
you got 10. I'll check her out and see what I got. Most of the company men, they tend to treat you like you don't know what the hell's going on. I've been doing this for 27 years, so I got a pretty good general idea of what's happening. That's all you gotta do is tell me and I'll do it. I'll tell you what, that's another thing. These company men want to come up here and give me. They better watch it. I'll knock their down.
Wayne slows it down, but he's feeling the pressure. He's still got a long way to go to catch up with the big dog and Longhorn. Coming up, Tim and his crew return to the big dog, but they're in for a big surprise.
You want to learn how to be a Eric, man, you pay attention, you hear me?
It's day five on the giant big dog rig. Tim and most of his crew didn't show up yesterday. They nearly cost the company $25,000 of lost drilling time. Tim and his crew made it back to the rig today. But it might be too late to save their jobs.
Now here you just don't come out here when you're that drunk. You got that much heavy equipment running around here. You just don't do that. I didn't feel safe by myself, so I didn't show up.
Now the boss EJ has to decide if he still wants Tim around.
If you'd have showed up, even if you'd showed up and you called Leon, that'd be different, man. But can't do that shit. Then all these other guys are gonna expect the same. You ain't no better out here. Friends are friends at home out here. you worked for me, just like Arturo, just like Sammy, just like any of them. And I keep, I'll have every motherfucker out here trying to take off every day. I mean, that's just part of it, man.
I worked hard for you, you know that.
Yeah, but damn, a good hand's a good hand, but a good hand that ain't here ain't worth the damn, you think if I'd have twisted off as much as you had, that I'd be working if I was drilling for a pusher? No. You know better than that.
TJ doesn't even have to say you're fired. Tim knows he spent his last day as a driller on the Big Dog.
I'm going to really hate it. I mean, I love this rig. I love the people I work with. I just hate to leave it. You got to go with him where you want it.
Tim probably doesn't remember much about his party, but this was one birthday he'll never forget. Driller is the big money job on the rig. A good driller can easily make more than $100,000 a year. So it wasn't hard for Big Dog to find Tim's replacement. Justin.
Just takes one screw up. One screw up and you're out of there and somebody else can replace you.
Justin needs to whip his rig back into shape. He's starting with the worm Derek, the only hand left from Tim's crew. Derek got to keep his job because he showed up for work yesterday.
You wait for him and he will show you and you learn. That's all I have to say.
But Justin might make him wish he hadn't.
You learn. You watch and learn. I know he can do it. I ain't never seen you do it, but once I see you do it, then we'll go from there. You watch and learn. You want to learn how to be a f***ing Derek, man. You pay attention. You hear me? All right.
I hear you, dude.
All right.
Justin's just more assertive. He's gonna let you know what needs to be done. He's gonna let you know with a purpose.
Justin's working his crew hard to get the pipe in the hole. And Big Dog back in the race. All three rigs are racing to 10,000 feet. Big Dog's slowdown let Viking gain some ground and allowed the Longhorn to pull away. But with thousands of feet to go, it's still anybody's race. Next time on Black Gold, at the Longhorn, Gerald brings the hammer down on the rig and the Roughnecks.
I'm putting your ass out that door.
Big Dog faces a shutdown.
I think our hole is starting to cave in on us, actually.
And it's Justin's worst nightmare.
It's what we call a well from hell.
At the Viking, the exhausted crew struggles to stay in the race.
You gotta keep it drilling, rain or shine, man.
And when the supervisor lays down the law, Wayne's had enough.
You get my